Hello and welcome. You're watching Rebooting India. I'm Shweta Rajpal Kohli. Time now to bring you up to speed with what's happening in the economy, the markets and the world of business. First, let's take a look at how the Sensex did today. Well, the stock markets ended today with some gains out there, but coming off the day's highs that we had seen earlier, heavyweights and select rate sensitive shares clearly leading the gains on the Sensex today after some important moves by the central bank that were announced yesterday, and that clearly had an impact on markets today. But finally, ending off the day's highs, the Sensex 88 points there in the green, 19,983. The Nifty also gained 22 points but came off the day's highs to finally end at 5,928. But it's the banking stocks that were clearly in focus today, with Yes Bank and ICICI gaining significantly again during the intraday trade, but finally then settling in for below than expected gains. But clearly banking stocks remaining some of those top movers today, with the Sensex and the Nifty also finally ending in the green. But what's the view coming in on the RBI decision to actually cut the short-term rate by 0.5%, a significant move that came in yesterday? We've got the rupee clearly weakening today, 61.79. That's where the rupee ended today. But let's get you a view now from A.V. Rajvare, a very well-known Forex and Treasury Risk Management consultant, who talks about why RBI may be sending out confusing signals by actually cutting the short-term rates but hiking the long-term rates.
The liquidity has been tight, and I think that will give a boost to business confidence. On the other hand, in some ways I find the RBI stance very confusing. On the one hand, they are dropping interest rates in terms of the MSF, this is the second drop, and in terms of the repo rate, they increased it. Now, inflation has gone up, so the latter sort of stands to reason. But then I don't know what exactly they are trying to do, what signal they are giving. So I am confused, but yes, broadly speaking, business would welcome what the RBI has done, because this gives a little more room to the banks to lend money. As far as the currency is concerned, I do not think that this is going to have any kind of, by itself, any kind of a significant impact in terms of the exchange rate.
All right, so confusing signals there from the RBI, but many believe that it will actually help boost confidence. Let's try and now bring you views coming in on the Reserve Bank's critical move to ease liquidity and reversing some of those emergency measures that were taken when the rupee had tanked to an all-time low. Several brokerages saying that the quick reduction of the short-term rate is a risky move. That's a view coming in from Morgan Stanley. Another view coming in that the comfort on the rupee levels is a key reason for RBI's move, and that another repo rate hike is not ruled out when the RBI moves next. That's a view coming from Religare. Another view coming in saying that you can expect a 0.25% hike in repo rate when the RBI meets on the 29th of October, saying the cost of short-term money will fall after RBI's move. And of course, the big news in the banking circles is the fact that the State Bank of India has got its first woman boss in its 207-year history. Arundhati Bhattacharya, who has taken charge today as the CEO and MD, in fact, held her first press conference today. And she says that the bank is extremely worried about bad loans and that there will be a new strategy to deal with bad loans.
There's no way that anybody can say that the war is over, or that we are going to lessen the intensity. If anything, I think we are going to make that intensity much, much more. And to that extent, you know, we have to ensure that whatever was done, we do it better, and also we use a lot of other weapons in order to control the NPAs. Other than IT also, I think we'll be looking at rationalizing structures as to how the NPAs are managed, who actually takes them up at what stage, in order to see that we get much better and quicker responses. We will also be looking at how to cut down on the time span that we normally take for resolving NPAs. Of course, means there is no doubt about it at all in any of our minds that NPA remains a top priority. It will remain a top priority till such time as we see the stress lessening in our books.
Moving on now to talk about sales of automobiles. Car sales have fallen 4.7% in the first 6 months of the fiscal year, the sharpest decline in half-year sales that we've seen since 2002-2003. And this according to figures that have been released by the Society of Indian Automobile Manufacturers, saying that despite a slight 0.7% uptick that we've seen in September when automakers sold over 150,000 cars, the industry continues to face a second consecutive year of falling demand as high interest rates and fuel costs keep a lid on consumer spending. In fact, the festive season has kicked in and retailers, automakers and real estate players are going out of their way to lure customers with freebies and discounts. But with the slowdown intensifying and inflation rising, people are still refraining from buying and demand clearly remains at an all-time low.
Freebies, discounts and sales galore. But will they entice consumers to spend this festive season? Rustamji Builders in Thane going the extra mile. For a flat costing over a crore, they promise buyers their home rent for 2 years, shaving off a little over 5 lakh rupees from the total cost.
What we are saying to the customer is that we are helping you with that rental for a period of 24 months, which enables you to take on the pre-EMI and helps you in your financial planning for a term of about 2 years.
But the big question is that are the buyers biting? Are shoppers being enticed by these offers, these discounts, these sales which are coming their way this festival season? And are they opening their purse strings just a little bit more?
If the discounts are there also, but it's not worth it. The prices are too much and I think already they are charging us in one way or the other.
Even for basic things, prices have gone too high. Basic things like milk, vegetables and all. So I don't think so much. Even in my circle, I've seen people are not so much interested in shopping and all.
So Yamaha offering 30% discount on accessories. Enough to convince Chaitanya Pohekar, who's just purchased his first motorcycle.
क्योंकि dealers को भी यही एक मौका रहता है क्योंकि अभी जैसे बहुत सारे लोग इसको अच्छे मुहूर्त पे गाड़ी लेना पसंद करते हैं तो dealers लोग भी उसी time discount देते हैं.
It's picking up really well. Daily walk-ins, inquiries, bookings. As for the bookings ratio, we have got a target of 300 on the counter sales, but we plan to achieve more than 300.
But no one's willing to say if these attempts have translated into increased sales. As of now, for them, it's just fingers crossed. With Imtiaz Jalil in Pune, in Mumbai, Meloni Bhatt for NDTV.
Well, that's the situation as far as Mumbai and Pune are concerned. And what's the situation in Delhi? Again, lots of festive discounts and offers, but are consumers biting those offers and willing to buy this festive season? Hina Gambhir finds out.
It's raining freebies and offers if you enter into any consumer durable stores at this point in time, especially now when the festive season has kicked in. I am at one such store, in fact, in New Delhi, one consumer durable store, and all around me I can see lots of offers. In fact, you look at this refrigerator, you buy this, and you have a wide range of gifts available, in fact, which will be given free to you if you buy this particular refrigerator. So a lot of store owners as well as manufacturers, in fact, are trying to give lots of discounts and lots of offers like this to attract more consumers at this point in time. The slowdown and inflation has hit the middle class hard, hurting demand for all products and forcing retailers to offer discounts to lure the customer.
This year we have to push a lot, we have to give a lot of free buys, a lot of offers to the customer to improve the sales. Last year was not there, even last 2-3 months were not good. Many customers wait for the offer which comes in Dashera, Diwali, they wait for it.